tonight. They lead in slugging percentage, and they also lead in runs scored and hits in conference play. They'll be the number one seed, of course, for the Phillips 66 Big 12 tournament coming up next Friday and Saturday. And we already know the seeds after yesterday's games. Iowa State took a doubleheader from Kansas. They won the second game in a walk-off in the eighth inning, 4-2. They won the opener 1-0. Texas Tech beat Kentucky, and then Texas last night held on to that 1-0 lead and beat Baylor 1-0. So that takes Baylor out of the equation. Baylor, if they end up tied with Kansas at 3-15, should they beat Texas today, it doesn't matter, because Kansas won the regular season series 2-1. So the Big 12 seeds are Oklahoma, number one, then OSU, Texas, Texas Tech, Iowa State, and Kansas, and Baylor's going to be on the outside looking in for the Big 12 tournament. And we'll give you those games in just a moment. Baylor plays Texas coming up at 1 o'clock. Kentucky plays Texas Tech outside the league to finish up regular season play for all of those schools at 1 o'clock. And then our game here at 11:30, followed by the regular game at 3 o'clock. So the Friday schedule for the Big 12 tournament looks like this. In Pool A, it's 4-6 Tech against Kansas. It's 1-4 Tech against OU against Tech, I should say. These games are 11-2, and then they'll play OU well against Kansas, 1-6 at 7:30. They'll play over on in Pool B, Oklahoma State. The 2 seed will get the 3 seed Texas. That game will be at 11 o'clock on Friday morning. Texas will play Iowa State at 2, and then Oklahoma State will play Iowa State at 5. The way it'll work on Saturday is the 11 o'clock games will play this way. Pool A third place will play Pool B third place at 11. Pool A second place will play Pool B second place at 1:30. And then at 4 o'clock, it'll be Pool A first place against Pool B first place, and that will determine the Big 12 champion. The Big 12 tournament champion will automatically get a bid to the NCAA tournament. It looks like right now there will be at least 3 teams and maybe 4 going from the Big 12. They might take Texas Tech, but Texas, Oklahoma State, and OU will probably all host, as well as be in the tournament. Iowa State is probably a bubble team right now at 31-22, but it depends on what they do in the tournament as to how far they might go when it's all said and done. Starting lineups and more for Bedlam when we come back after a timeout. This is Cowgirl Softball from Learfield, IMG College.
Is that okay? I don't know. Will it fit like right there?
We'll have to move some stuff over, but yeah, that's where you need it. Stick it right there.
Try not to get it on your stuff.
No, that's fine.
Yeah, cool. That'll be a little bit clearer. Switch the mic so it'd be a little clearer and not so echoey.
Off at third base, Molly Alou. Alou has the left field spot. She'll bat second. Kaylee Clifton at second base will bat third. Joshua Mallow will bat fourth and play right field. Grace Green at first base bats fifth. Nicole Mendez in center field hits sixth. Reagan Rogers, the designated player, hitting for the pitcher Lopez, bats seventh. Lindsay Elam, the catcher, batting eighth. And Grace Lyons bats ninth and plays shortstop. For the Cowgirls, the lineup today, Riley Bayless in left leads it off. Samantha Schau playing first, batting second. Maddie Sue Montgomery at second base bats third. Shayla Richburg in the cleanup spot will play right field. Batting fifth is Cheyenne Factor in center. Taylor Lynch, the designated player again today, hitting for the pitcher Samantha Clakely and batting sixth. Sydney Pennington, the third baseman, hits seventh. Raquel Dominguez gets the start at catcher today, and she'll bat eighth. Kylie Naomi is the shortstop, batting ninth for head coach Kenny Gajewski in his fourth year, 146-85 at Oklahoma State. OU leads the series 90-71. The Cowgirls have only 7 wins in the Big 12 era, all of them either here or in Oklahoma City on a neutral side in the Big 12, and there has not been a sweep in this series for the Cowgirls since 93. That will continue this year, and no wins in this series since 2011 for Oklahoma State, and they were 3-28 in their last 31 games going back to 2008. In this series, it's been dominated in the last 15 years in particular by Oklahoma. We'll have the first pitch of Bedlam when we come back after a timeout. This is the Bedlam Series and Cowgirl Softball from Learfield IMG College.
And we are America with a play of our national anthem.
Go ahead and play them all. Center, Michelle Richburg is in right. Third baseman is Sydney Pennington. Kylie Naomi is the shortstop. The second baseman, Maddie Sue Montgomery, starting her 231st game today as a Cowgirl. And at first base is Samantha Schau. Raquel Dominguez is the catcher today, and the pitcher is Samantha Clakely. Clakely is the right-hander out of Texas, transferred here from Texas Arlington out of Carthage, Texas High School, 9-3 with a 2.22 ERA. This is her 21st appearance. It's her 14th start. She has 4 complete games, 79 innings, 73 hits, 25 earned runs, 31 walks, and 41 strikeouts. She has pitched better in conference play this year and in some of the non-conference games, too, and teams are hitting .233 against her. Sydney Marrero leads it off, a .431 hitter, 1-for-2 with a walk in the game last night down in Norman. 69 hits, 16 homers, 49 runs batted in, and a nominee for National Player of the Year. We're underway. First pitch is a fastball high and away for ball one. Our umpires today are Terry Holt behind the plate, Brian Crochet, who worked the plate last night, is over at first, and Frederick Ewald, who did not work the series last night, is at third base today. He goes Bubba Ewald, so I guess he was there last night. Here's the pitch, and it's inside, a curveball, and it's low for a ball, and it's 2-0. They have him as his official name, but he goes by Bubba. So he did work first base last night. He's at third base today, and he'll work the plate for game two this afternoon. 2-0 to Romero, and the pitch from Clakely. And a fastball on the inside corner is a strike at the knees, and the count is 2-1. Crowd still filing in here to Cowgirl Stadium. A lot of folks in the outfield today. The sun is shining through the clouds here, and not a bad day weather-wise here at the ballpark. We'll tell you more about that here in a second. And the 2-1 from Clakely is swung on and fouled back, and the count is even, 2 balls and 2 strikes. It's 68 degrees with a south wind at 15 miles per hour. And it will warm up as the day goes on here. We had a threat of rain earlier this morning and a few drops, but it cleared on out and has moved on to the east. Clakely has a 2-2 coming, and it's outside and high for ball three. Cowgirls 13-3 in the league this year. Again, going to finish second. And a full count here to the leadoff hitter Romero with Ovio up next. Clakely looks in and has the sign and comes home on 3-2. And it bounces up there for ball four. So a leadoff walk, and that's the way the game began last night for Oklahoma. And Ovio is at the plate. She is 1-for-3 last night. And her average, .388. 7 homers and 31 runs batted in. There are 15 seniors between these two teams on the squads today. 4 for Oklahoma, or actually 8 for Oklahoma State and 7 for OU. First pitch. Fastball is over but low for ball one. Senior out of state of California. 4-year starter for Coach Patty Gasso in her 25th season here at OU. Left-handed batter with some power. And the pitch on the way. They show bunt and they pull the bat back. It's a strike at the letters and the count is 1-1. As I mentioned last night, Oklahoma 40 out of 51 in the stolen base category. The Cowgirls 49 out of 53. And that didn't change last night. When that error was put up on the board, by the way, in that play where Bayless took third, they took the stolen base off the board. Here's a fly ball to right center. That's a base hit. The lead runner will go to third and slides in. And Ovio has a single, as she did last night. Instead of it being first and second with nobody out, like it was in the first inning last night for OU, it's first and third and nobody out. And a threat right away here for the Sooners, and Kaylee Clifton comes up. Another senior out of Wayne, Oklahoma, down south of Norman. Home run last night, 1-for-3 with a run scored and a run batted in. A solo shot, her 14th of the year. She's hitting .403. Slugging percentage of .884 and an on-base percentage of .538. Is the captain of this team for Oklahoma. First and third, first pitch with the infield in at the corners is outside for ball one. And again, they start behind on the hitters. And that happened a lot last night for Samantha Schau. Schau comes over and has a word from first base with Clakely. Infield back and deep all the way around in the outfield. Clifton, a right-handed batter. The pitch taking, and it is low, says the umpire. I think Dominguez thought it was a strike. 2 balls and no strikes. Clifton started to swing but didn't really release the bat, and so it was a ball. 2-0 to Clifton. OU, the number one seed for the Big 12, and again, 8 time in a row now, conference champion. The pitch, a bunt, and a good one, a squeeze play. Here comes the runner. She'll score, a throw to first, out. They'll get an RBI out of it as the play is made by the third baseman Pennington coming in. And it's a safety squeeze, and it's a straight up squeeze, and it's going to be a 5-3 put out. And it's going to be a run for the Sooners. 1-0 as coming in is Romero. So the other runner goes to second, Ovio, and the hitter is Jocelyn Hollow. Sophomore, 408, 13 homers and 43 runs batted in. Right-handed batter, first pitch is a fastball low for ball one. all righties in this lineup except for a couple of hitters. Mendez, one of them, who will bat later in this inning if it keeps going. And Abreu, who's down at second base. The pitch. Fastball inside corner for a strike by Clayton. And the count, 1-1. Sooners scored on back-to-back homers last night in the fourth and on back-to-back doubles in the sixth to win 3-0. The Cowgirls held to an infield single off the glove of the third baseman. Runner at second with one out, 1-0 Sooners. The pitch, taking, that's a strike on the outside corner. Thought about swinging, but held up. And let's see if the third base umpire comes over and calls that a illegal pitch. They did, and it's a 2-1 count. So that'll go the other way, as the third base umpire, Bubba Ewald, called that an illegal pitch, 2-0. So now working from behind again, the pitch hit on the ground. That's a foul ball off the hitter at the plate, and that got the left leg or ankle, one or the other, of Olo, and she'll go back to home plate. Ball rolled up the area between third and the circle, but it was a foul ball. So now the count even, 2-2. Sooners with a 1-0 lead here in the top of the first inning, trying to take this series in game two here today. And the Cowgirls have not won since 2011 in matchups with these two teams. Blakely looks in, rocks and fires, swinging a foul off the end of the bat and to the right side and out of play. Sooners are in the first base dugout, the Cowgirls in the third base dugout. And they're letting folks stand by the bullpens, and in the case of the Cowgirl bullpen, in the bullpen today, down the left field line. Blakely again on 2-2. Up and in for ball three, that nearly hit her. So a full count, 3-2, and the Sooners might put a play on here with only one out. This big crowd still filing in here to Cowgirl Stadium. The 3-2 coming now to Olo from Clakely. Taking, that is ball four, just off the outside corner. They throw behind the runner at second, and she gets back in there safe and a walk. Well, fans don't like that call over the non-call by the home plate umpire, Terry Holt. And here's Grace Green. Mentioned Olo last night was 2-for-3, had one of those two doubles. Green had the other one. That scored the runs back-to-back in the sixth inning. Or the run that scored. Make it 3-0. Here's the first pitch, and a fastball is outside and high for ball one. Already there's activity in the Cowgirl bullpen. In the bullpen for Oklahoma State is Logan Simonek. Here's the pitch. And a floater, that's in there for a strike. And the count is 1-1. Sooners again lead the nation in batting average, slugging percentage. Their opponents hit just 153 against their pitching while they hit 366. Pitch hit up the middle and fielded by the shortstop. They'll tag first, or second rather, and go to first and get a double play and get out of the inning. And another double play turned by Oklahoma State. That's their 20th ground ball double play of the year. And it was fielded by the shortstop. And on that play, Kylie Naomi going to her left stopped the ball from going up the middle that probably would have scored a run. That's the third double play the Sooners have hit into in this two-game series. And it results in the two outs that get the Cowgirls out of the inning. So in the inning for Oklahoma, one run on one hit, two walks, a bunt squeeze play for an RBI, and as it turns out, one man left on base. So we go to the bottom of one, Oklahoma 1 and the Cowgirls coming up, and this is Cowgirl Softball in the Bedlam Series from Learfield, IMG Commons.
Thank you.
Clifton, and Green. The catcher, Lindsey Elam, again today. And the pitcher, Mariah Lopez, 16-1 with a 1.11 ERA. It's her 24th appearance, her 19th start, and the first pitch to Riley Bayless. Fastball up and a swing and a miss for strike one. Out there in the circle, Lopez, out of Saugus, California. She's a junior, two-line letter winner for Coach Patty Gasso. Right-hander rocks and fires, and a swing and a miss on a ball that was up. That's another rise ball, and that's strike two. Bayless, Shaw, and Montgomery in this inning. The rest of the numbers on Lopez. Seven complete games, 94 and two-thirds innings, 51 hits, just 15 earned runs, 132 strikeouts, and 22 walks. Very much a power pitcher, and teams are hitting just 156 against her. The next pitch is high. Laid off that one, and it's a ball and two strikes to Bayless, hitting 354. Big 12 leading 37 walks, and also leads in walks per game. Started and played in all 50 games for the Cowgirls this year, seven homers and 32 runs batted in. Here's the 1-2, and a swing and a miss, and another strikeout. The Cowgirls were struck out 13 times last night by the left-hander Juarez, who will likely see in game two today. Here's Samantha Shaw. Shaw, the senior, hitting 336, 15 home runs, which has tied the record for number of home runs in a single season by a Cowgirl. Maddie Sue Montgomery did that last year. And she leads the team in runs batted in with 46. Right-handed batter out of East Bernard, Texas. Transferred out of Texas A&M. First pitch, fastball high and away for ball one. And the wind blowing out toward left field today, which helps all these power hitters that can pull the ball. Helps people can hit it the other way as well from the left side. Big crowd here in Stillwater. Here's the next pitch. And a fastball at the letters, a strike, and we're even at one ball, one strike. We're in the first inning. OU has already scored to make it a 1-0 game here in game one of our doubleheader. Trying to take the series again this year. Cowgirls have not won two in this series since 2010. The pitch is in the dirt low. Two balls and one strike. Sooners will be the number one seed, I would think, nationally when the selection show comes around in about a week. Regardless of what happens at the Big 12, the pitch, swinging a foul back, and I say that because UCLA lost earlier this weekend. So if the Cowgirls could win a game in this series, there's even a chance that they could move up in the standings. Now, maybe not make the top 10, but might move up a spot. RPI is just going to get better by playing Oklahoma, let alone what happens against them. 2-2 count, the pitch from Lopez. A swing and a pop-up down the right side. That'll make the fan area down there behind the first base dugout. So the count even to Shout, two balls and two strikes. 220 to dead center here, 190 down the lines, and about 205 to the alleys in left and right here. And again, the wind blows out toward left today here at Cowgirl Stadium and will all afternoon. The 2-2 from Lopez, fastball low and away, and it's 3-2. Lopez is 5'8", and she doesn't have the big windmill motion, but she throws hard, and again is a strikeout pitcher. Full count to Shaw with Montgomery on deck. 3-2 with one out, the pitch. Swing, a mile-high pop-up. That's back our way. And over, well, on top of the press box to my left. If you find that foul ball, turn it into the parking table. So the count stays 3-2. We're in the bottom of the first inning here. Game one of our doubleheader. This is the makeup game from Friday night's rainout. Lopez again coming to Shaw on 3-2. Swing, and this is popped up again, and that'll make the seats, I think, behind home plate. Now, let's see. No, it's caught by the catcher. Down below us here, Elam had just enough room in front of the screen to make that catch for the out. I had to wait a moment there to make sure she caught it, and it didn't hit the screen. So here's Maddie Sue Montgomery. And Shaw is a pop-up victim, two up, two down. Montgomery starting her 231st game as a Cowgirl. She's three away from tying the record set last year of Vanessa Shippey. 354, six homers, and 43 runs batted in. First pitch to her is hit in the air down the line and right. That's a base hit into the corner, cut off by the right fielder. And Alo will get that ball back in, but a solid single for Montgomery, who is also one RBI away from 200 in her career. And only people wearing OU uniforms have done that in the history of the Big 12. There been five of them. She'll have a chance to join that group today. Here's Michaela Richport, sophomore out of Broken Bow, 307 with 12 homers and 34 runs batted in. The Cowgirls have their first hit of the game here in the first inning. Two outs and a runner at first, and Lopez's first pitch, a high fastball and a swing and a miss for strike one. Throws that rise ball very effectively. We'll see if she comes back with it here again. Richburg was at the plate last night when the bases were loaded and struck out. 1-0 Sooners here in the first. The pitch, same pitch, swing and a miss, strike two. Just threw it by her. There were a couple times, last night when Juarez was hitting 70 on the radar gun. Lopez has got to be around that too. Montgomery at first with two outs. Richburg at the plate, the pitch, way outside and high. The two home run leaders on the Cowgirls, who have 65 dingers on the year, 15 by Schau and 12 by Richburg, and they have not had double-figure home run leaders like that in a career season ever, till this year. The 1-2 from Lopez, swing and a miss, struck her out, and the inning is over. That's two Ks in the inning and 15 for the Sooners in the game today and last night combined. So the Cowgirls, no runs, a hit, and one left, and after one, OU leads the Cowgirls 1-0 here in Stillwater. This is the Bedlam Series and Cowgirl softball from Learfield IMG College.
Keep up with the Cowboys and Cowboys on OKState.com. The official always got on the website. Check out the most up-to-date and latest information 24 hours a day. Find all sports stats, schedules, views, and much more. OKState.com, the official OSU and Athletics website.
Far too fast to prepare for these. Tripping the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling these vulture wings. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of Maine. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could beat the one. I was born to burn. I was born for these.
Seed in the Big 12 tournament. Baylor plays Texas at 1 o'clock. Tech plays Kentucky outside the league. The wrap up of the regular season for the Red Raiders at 1. And we have a second game coming up here at 3 o'clock. Leading off is Nicole Mendez, the center fielder for Oklahoma. She'll be followed by Rogers, the designated player today, who played last night as a pinch runner, and also Lindsey Elam. And the first pitch, a strike on a swing and a miss. Mendez, junior left-handed batter, 347, four homers and 31 runs batted in. Samantha Clakely in the circle, here's the pitch. Another good pitch, it was just low and inside, and a ball and a strike. Patty Gasso, the 25-year head coach here at Oklahoma. Jennifer Rocha is the associate head coach. She coaches down at first base. JT Gasso and Kaylani Ricketts are the other two coaches. A line drive to left. That's a base hit over the third baseman, and the left fielder gets that back in very quickly. Bayless for the Cowgirls, and Mendez with a leadoff single. So the leadoff man has been on for two innings in a row here for Oklahoma, and the hitter will be Reagan Rogers. Rogers was a pinch runner last night for Elam. After Elam got on with a single, she'll bat next, their catcher. Rogers has been a very good player this year for them. She's been a four-year player for Patty Gasso out of Blanchard, out of Bridge Creek High School. First pitch is a strike on the inside corner. That community just went through the 20th anniversary of the tornado that basically wiped it out back on May 3rd of 1999. We've done some football and other high school sports down there at Bridge Creek. Nice folks down there. Here's the pitch. A show bunt, and the ball goes off the catcher, and the runner's going to go down to second base. That pitch was high, but probably should have been fielded by Dominguez, and they should call that a pass ball, but we'll see how they score it. So the runner down to second, Mendez, and that's a ball, 1-1. Because the pitch was out of the zone, they might call it a wild pitch. So runner in scoring position, Rogers showing bunt a moment ago. Let's see what she does here on 1-1. She is taking, and the pitch is low and away for ball two. Right-handed batter, her number's 327. This is just her 20th start of the year, but she's played in 46 games, 5 homers and 15 runs batted in. Has had some home runs this year. The pitch, swinging a ground ball to third. They'll freeze the runner, look her back, and go to first for the out. Now they'll throw to third, and she comes off the bag and is tagged out. Chow looked right at the play as the play was made at first on the runner, Rogers, coming down the line on the throw by Pennington. And all of a sudden, here comes Mendez trying for third. Well, she might have made it the first time, but she overslid third base and got tagged again by Pennington, and she is out. And the play goes 2-5. Make it 3-5 with the third first baseman involved there. So here's Lindsay Elam with the bases empty and two outs. So there's two innings in a row that the Cowgirl defense has come through again. Elam, the sophomore catcher, 318, 4 homers, 23 runs batted in, and takes a strike at the knees, and the count is 0-1. Just hoping that they can catch fire here, this Cowgirl team, in some way, here in this ball game this afternoon, or either one of them, as far as that goes. I'm going to call an illegal pitch again, so it's ball one. Have to stay between the lines. Here's the 1-0. Swain, a ground ball off the bat to first and out there, and the inning is over. Played in front of the bag by Shaw, three unassisted, and after the leadoff single and the man thrown out at third base, the Sooners do not leave anybody on base. Had a wild pitch. They scored in the inning as well. And so after an inning and a half, it's Oklahoma 1, Oklahoma State nothing. This is the Bedlam Series and Cowgirl Softball from Learfield, IMG College. Game one of our doubleheader today as the Cowgirls trail 1-0 here to the Oklahoma Sooners. Cheyenne Factor will lead it off for the Cowgirls here in the second inning. And just a reminder, we'll have probably an hour break between games today, maybe more than that, depends on the length of this first game. And so we'll have you enjoy Bob Kingsley's Country Countdown, and then we'll come back to programming here at 2:45 at Cowgirl Stadium. Cheyenne Factor, the freshman center fielder for Oklahoma State, 351 with 6 homers and 32 runs batted in. Mariah Lopez throws up and in for ball one, and we're underway here in the second inning. I am battling a cold, the worst time of year to have one. I thought it was over it, and did the game last night, and not much better today, but we'll persevere. Here's the 1-0, and a fastball is low for ball one. The problem is, if I don't have to talk very much, I do okay, but not today because I'm doing a doubleheader. The same thing Rex had a couple weeks ago, the postnasal drip and just a head cold, not anything else. The 2-0 from Lopez, that's high for ball three. Factor last night, 0-3. Now the pitcher and catcher will come out and have a conversation in the circle as Elam talks to Lopez. In just an OU team that reloads every year, and again with 7 seniors and a number of other veterans back. They have been the number one team for about the last month now. 3-0 the count to the leadoff hitter Factor, then Lynch and Pennington. The pitch, strike inside corner. and the count 3-1. Terry Holt, the home plate umpire, you can hear him all the way up here. Crowd quiet at the moment here at Cowgirl Stadium. Factor on 3-1, the pitch to her. That's a strike at the letters, and it's 3-2. Brian Crochet again down at first, and Bubba Ewald down at third. Outfield shaded toward left, they give her right center. Factor out of Yukon, Oklahoma. How about those Cowboy baseballers, two in a row against number 2 Oregon State? The pitch fouled back into the press box to our right. And a full count again, 3-2 to Factor. Cowgirls were held to just one hit last night. That was an infield single off the glove of the third baseman, Romero, by Springfield. And that could have been ruled an error. Baseball, it probably would have been, but softball, it wasn't. The 3-2, swinging a foul back to the screen. Cowgirls are in the home white today with the orange piping. The Sooners are in the gray uniforms today with the white cream-colored outlined red numbers and the red sleeves, and if they're wearing visors, and most of these girls are, the visors are crimson. Factor battling up there, the 3-2 again, a swing and a miss. She went up, up, and up, and a foul tip held by the catcher for the strikeout. That's the third K already in the game for this right-hander. Taylor Lynch is the hitter, the designated player out of Red Oak, Texas. Penny Gasso sees something she doesn't like, and she comes out immediately to talk to her infielders and the batter. So this is a very one-sided conversation with the head coach, whatever this is about in the circle. They're all listening. They're not saying a word to her. Normally when Patty comes out, this is a compliment. It's a one-sided conversation, and it very much is right now. She is getting her team's attention about something. She will walk back to the dugout. Kind of like that old ad. When Merrill Lynch talks, or whoever it was, people listen. Well, when Patty Gasso talks, people listen. You play for her. Now Taylor Lynch will get to stand in against Lopez. Lynch is hitting 273, 19 runs batted in. First pitch to her is blown away for ball one. If there's an award for playing injured, she should get it. She tore her ACL back in March. She's played in every game this year but three and has started in all the games she's played in. Wearing that right knee brace, it goes almost from the middle of her hip down to her ankle. Here's a swing and a foul. Look out down there in the bullpen. Left side out of play. And a long strike, one ball and one strike. So for an OU team that gives, or scores rather, 8 runs a game, to only give up 3, the Cowgirls did pretty well last night. 2 of those on home runs. The 1-1. Check swing. They're going to say if she went around, and no, says the third base umpire. So a ball and a fastball up, and it's 2-1. In fact, all the runs scored were by extra base hits last night. Back-to-back doubles that scored a run in the 6th inning, and the back-to-back home runs in the 4th. Sooners have 2 hits and the pitch. And a swing and a miss by Lynch for a strike, and it's 2-2. And the Cowgirls have the 1 hit by Maddie Sue Montgomery. Cowgirls have turned a double play, and they've also thrown out a runner trying to go from 2nd to 3rd on a ground ball out. So good defense, 2 innings in a row. And they have 3 double plays in this series. Sooners have only grounded into 7 of them, or actually 8 now all year. Pitch is high, and it's ball 3. Take that back. They've grounded into 16 now, including 2 in this series. Now Lopez on 3-2 will come home, and a swing and a tap foul off the end of the bat back to the screen. Just got a piece of that one. And the count is full, 3-2. And this game will probably be over 1:30, 1:45. We'll have at least an hour break between games. Excuse me, for game number 2, which is still scheduled for 3 o'clock. Here's the full count pitch to Lynch, and she fouls it back left on the screen again, out of play. Kenny Gajewski coaching down at third, Stacy Pestrak down at first. Jeff Cottrell is In the dugout is the pitching coach. Cody Barham is the volunteer assistant coach for Oklahoma State. He keeps the book and a few other things down there. So again, Lynch up here battling on 3-2 against Lopez. The pitch. Swing and a ball hit off the end of the bat. Shortstop has it. Long throw out at first. That ball kind of had a little tailspin on it a little bit. And Lyons wanted to make sure she had the right play going there. Almost overran the ball, but Lynch grounds out 6-3 as she was able to recover. And here's Pennington. Sydney Pennington, the sophomore co-captain out of Sand Springs, 262 with 9 homers and 32 runs batted in. Crowd still coming in here to Cowgirl Stadium. And the outfield is ringed with people, 2, 3 deep, 4 deep in some places today. They'll get their suntan today. First pitch. And that's a strike right down the middle to Pennington. Cowgirls only were given 2 walks last night by Juarez, who doesn't walk very many people anyway. 1 to Shao and 1 to Maddie Sue Montgomery. Next one from Lopez. Swing and a miss on that rise ball, and it's strike 2. You think that ball's going to be about waist high, and you're ready for it, and it's up around your neck. And it's 0-2. Already 3 strikeouts today for Juarez. Or matchup for Lopez. It gives her 135 on the year. The pitch swung on and fouled back. We will likely see Giselle Juarez in game number 2 today. Might go with Samantha Shaw, but we'll see. Again, one less day for these pitchers with a Friday night rainout and playing a doubleheader today. Here's the 0-2. And that hit the batter, I think. No, she's going to have to stay put. Pennington saying it caught her on the wrist or the hand. The home plate umpire said it hit the knob of the bat. And they're going to get some conversation about this out by the circle with the 3 umpires. They're going to say it hit the bat, and that's the right call. Kenny Gajewski's going to argue about it, but that thing came off whatever it hit too hard to have not clipped something harder than a hand. If it hits you in the hand, you're going to be walking around trying to shake it off. You might even hurt something instead. Especially if it hits that little knob around your wrist. But that got the knob of the bat more than they got anything else, so it's still 0-2. So Pennington gets new life out of all this. And with 2 outs, the pitch. Swing and a miss and a strikeout, and the inning's over, and that's 4 Ks for Mariah Lopez. Cowgirls up and down in order, and after 2, it's OU 1, OSU nothing. This is Cowgirl Softball in the Bedlam Series from Learfield IMG College.
The open shopping destination for OSU fans on Cowgirl Softball Game Day.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you, David. Seedings for the Big 12 tournament. OU is going to be number 1. Oklahoma State is 2. Texas 3. Tech 4. Iowa State's 5th. And Kansas makes the tournament despite losing 2 yesterday to Iowa State. Iowa State 31-22. Their overall record. They still got a shot at the NCAA tournament as a 4 seed somewhere. So they could have a chance to have 5 teams out of this conference in the Big 12. And especially if Tech and Iowa State make some noise in the Big 12 next weekend. Remember, it's pool play. So everybody plays 2 on Friday. There are 6 games. And then 3 on Saturday. Grace Lyons is the only person not to bat yet for OU. And she'll lead it off here in the third. Right-handed batter takes a fastball strike from Samantha Clayton. Lyons, a freshman hitting 268. She's one of 2 freshmen in the lineup here for Oklahoma. 6 homers and 24 runs batted in. Lyons is out of Peoria, Arizona. Here's the 0-1. Another fastball runs away, and it's low for a ball 1-1. Patty Gasso has a couple of pipelines. California is one of them. Obviously, she's from that part of the country, coached at Long Beach State before coming to OU. The other is the Phoenix area out there in southern Arizona. Here's the pitch and an off-speed delivery, and that is just, that's a strike, late called by the umpire. And they're going to call an illegal pitch again. That's the third time that Bubba Ewald has called an illegal pitch, so the count will go to 2-1 instead of 1-2. Again, you got to stay within those lines that are out there between the front of the circle and the pitching plate. That's technically what it's called. Here's the 2-1, and that is in there for a strike. And it's the third base umpire's job with a right-handed pitcher to watch that. It's the first baseman's job, the first base umpire, rather, his job to watch a left-handed pitcher. 2-2 the count. Lyons, Romero, and Uview. The pitch, that is low. Cowboy baseball is at 2 o'clock today, a 1:30 dugout show, and it'll be a local broadcast today on 93.7 KSPI-FM. Next week, it's Bedlam. Three games, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and then Baylor in town, and then the Big 12 tournament. Pitch, swing, a line drive to right, and that's a base hit in front of the right fielder. No chance for Richburg to come and get that one. And it's going to be a single for Lyons, an opposite field hit, and the leadoff hitter's on for the third straight inning. Well, the Cowgirls have had successful defense, a double play, and a runner thrown out going from second to third on a ground ball in the last two innings. So let's see what they do here. Romero's up, walked, and scored the game's only run on a squeeze play back in the first inning. Sooners have three hits now, one in each of the first three innings. First pitch, almost hit her inside, ball one. Romero again a nomination for National Player of the Year like Vanessa Shippey was last year for the Cowgirls. And there's a website you can vote on that if you'd like. Romero out of San Diego, California. The pitch. Fastball, and that is up. And it's 2-0. May have been off the outside corner. Logan Semenek still throwing in the Cowgirl bullpen. Likely here in this 2-0 spot to the hitter, the pitch. And a fastball strike at the knees on the inside corner, and it's two balls and a strike. To Romero, who walked her first time up, and as I mentioned, scored the game's only run. Her walk's just her 10th of the year. She has two of them in this series. She's usually swinging with an on-base percentage of nearly 500. The 2-1. Swing, and a ball hit a mile, but foul, left side. That may make the bullpen. And they bounce around down there and get out of the way of that one, and it's two balls and two strikes. Cowgirl bullpen and the hitting cages are down the left field line here to the left and out of play. That's where that ball wound up. So a long strike, and it's 2-2. And the next one, swing, and a ball hit deep to left. That's a moonshot that's going to get out of here for a home run. Romero hits number 17. That leads the Sooners, who now have 95 home runs. RBI's number 50 and 51. It's a two-run shot. That's the third home run off Cowgirl pitching in this series, and it's a 3-0 lead for the Oklahoma Sooner. That's what they do. They just hit the ball a ton. They average two home runs a game. They average eight runs a game. They've matched last night's run total here in the third inning today. And Kenny Gajewski may be making a pitching change right now. They have Sprang now warming up in the bullpen, but they had Semenek, and so the day is done, at least for now, for the starter, Samantha Clakely. And we'll have a pitching change coming up for Oklahoma State. So let's take that time out with the score, Oklahoma 3 and OSU nothing. And this is Oklahoma State Cowgirl softball.
I don't know.
game for the Cowgirls will pitch here in the third inning in this first game today. Two-thirds of an inning last night to now allow a run or a hit in facing two batters. And on the season, and lady from Piedmont is 7-3 with a 3.13 ERA. This is her 24th appearance, second only to Schaub. 62 and two-thirds innings, 68 hits, 28 earned runs, 39 strikeouts, 24 walks. She has pitched better in the last month and a half, and especially against the good teams going back a couple of seasons, and teams are hitting 275 against her. She will face Ubu here. The left-handed batter already has a single in this game. Home run by Romero chases Clakely. Three runs, four hits, all of them earned. She walked two and didn't strike out anybody. So it's a 3-0 Sooner lead, and the first pitch here is high for ball one. Seminac came in and got the final outs last night in the sixth inning after the Sooners scored a run. Here's the 1-0. Low for a ball, and it's 2-0. Hubbew single to left her first time up, raising her batting average now over 390. So another extra base hit results in a run here in this game. Seminac stands back in, and here's her next pitch, and it's a off-speed pitch high, and the count is 3-0. So three balls and no strikes with Clifton on deck, and already a 3-0 lead for the Sooners here in the third inning. Seminac being asked to get outs here. The pitch. That is a strike at the letters, and it's 3-1. Yeah, you hear the fans. They like that. Sooner fans don't. They just start yelling Boomer Sooner. That's what they do. So the count 3-1. I don't blame them. They got the number one team in the country. Again, Seminac 3-1 from the right-hander is low and away for ball four. So the third walk already given to OU in this game. Three straight have reached base to start the inning, and here is Clifton. Clifton, the senior second baseman, had a squeeze play bunt for an RBI her first time up. Stands in there with a chance to continue the inning. She's been a four-year player for Patty Gasso, and the right-hander from Wayne, first pitch, taking, it's a strike at the letters, and the count is 0-1 from Logan Seminac. Again, Baylor, Texas will get started here in about 45 minutes. The game doesn't really mean much because Baylor is already out as far as the Big 12, and Texas clinched third place a week ago. So playing for pride today down at Red and Charlene McCombs Field. There's a pitch high for a ball, and the count is 1-1. If you're wondering about Ubu as far as steals, she is 5 out of 5 on the year. Sooners don't run all that much, 40 out of 51 on the year. They can motor around. The pitch, swing a ground ball off the first baseman's glove and into the right field corner. It was a fair ball. It ended up in foul territory. Sooners will take the turn, and they'll score a run. A throw home is late, and the other runner ends up at third. They'll probably score a double and an RBI for Clifton. That adds to the lead as Ubu comes around to score to make it 5-0. Should be actually just 4-0. The scoreboard is incorrect, as the other runner, Clifton, ends up at second base, or make it at third base. That ball hits Schau's glove next to the bag at first in fair territory. And the RBI for Clifton gives her 42 now on the year. And another extra base hit for Oklahoma. That's their fifth and the second in this inning, and it brings up Hollow and a chance to break the game wide open here. Runner at third, the infield cheats in. Here's the first pitch, and it's inside and low for ball one. The wind has died down some here. It was blowing pretty good when we got here about 11 o'clock, and or actually about 10:30, and all of a sudden the wind here in the last 20 minutes has died down a little bit. Here's the 1-0, And a fastball is upstairs, and it's two balls and no strikes. Hollow walked her first time up against the starter, Clakely, who's been taken out of the game. Simonek has not gotten an out yet. Gabby Sprang continues to throw in the Cowgirl bullpen. The pitch started to swing and tapped it foul back behind home plate. Just a piece of that ball, so a strike two and one. Cowgirls have only won 7 times in the Big 12 era. That's 1996-97 to now in this series. And have not won at all since 2011. Here's the 2-1. Fastball strike at the belt, and the count is 2-2 on the inside half. 4-5-0 for the Sooners. They're still batting in this third inning. Cowgirls 0-1-0. They're hit a single by Montgomery in the first. 2-2 pitch. And an off-speed pitch and strike 3 on the outside corner. And Olo doesn't strike out very much. Just 12 times now in the season. She's caught looking on an off-speed delivery. That is the first out of the inning. So that'll bring up Grace Green, who hit into a 6-3 double play and a ball that was headed for center field her first time up. Right-handed batter. 13 home runs on the year. First pitch. Another floater. That's a strike. And the count is 0-1. Walk single. First inning. Squeeze play bunt. RBI. Walk double play. Second inning. Single. Ground ball out that threw out the lead runner. And then a ground out. The pitch. Swing a ground ball. And Shaw has it. They'll look the runner back to third and tag the runner out at first base, who might have been out of the baseline anyway. And a out recorded, 3 unassisted there. In this inning, a single, a 2-run homer, a walk, an RBI double, a strikeout, and now a ground out. So Clifton stays at third with 2 outs, and here's Mendez, who singled her first time up. If OU is not the number one national seed when the selection show comes up in about a week, I'll be very surprised. Here's the first pitch. Ground ball foul outside third and out of play. Of course, if the Cowgirls could come back and win both games of this doubleheader today, it might change some voters' minds, but I don't think it'll change it very much. Cowgirls should be in line to host a regional here in 2 weeks. That announcement comes up in less than 9 days from now, less than 8 days from now, as a matter of fact. Simonek looks in, rocks and fires, and a fastball tap foul back to the screen, and that's quickly strike two. So 4 runs on 5 hits for Oklahoma. And as the temperature has come up today, they have warmed up. Started at 68 degrees, we're now at 71. Very pleasant day, though, here in Stillwater. The 0-2 with 2 outs. Swinging a ball hit back to the screen foul. Off the end of that big long bat these softball players use. 34, 35-inch bats. Barrels aren't very big. They don't need to hit a big ball with a large barrel. Can you imagine the force some of those balls would be hit with if you tried it with a baseball bat that big? The 0-2. Taking strike 3, inside corner, a punch out, and the inning's over. Simonet comes back, excuse me, after giving up a walk and a double to strike out 2 and get a ground ball out. But the damage done in the inning, 3 runs for the Sooners on 3 hits, a walk and 1 left. Sooners have left 2 on the afternoon. The bottom of 3, it's Oklahoma 4 and the Cowgirls nothing. This is Cowgirl Softball and the Bedlam Series from Learfield IMG College. OU is 8-1 in games where they've scored 3 to 5 runs, and right now they're at 4, so they sit right in the middle of that. They've been a very good team on Sunday. They're 10-0. Plus, they've only lost 2 games all year. Their loss is to Florida State, and the other loss to UCLA, who has lost this weekend, number 2 team in the country. Here's Raquel Dominguez, who did not play last night, the sophomore catcher for the Cowgirls out of Victorville, California, not far from Los Angeles. 244 with 4 runs batted in. This is her 19th start. She pops it up back to the screen on the first pitch from Mariah Lopez, and that's strike one. Sooners have had a leadoff man on in every inning. Defensively, they have 4 strikeouts from Lopez, and they only hit a solid single by Montgomery back in the first. The pitch, swing and a miss. Root Byer, there's that rise ball again, and it's strike two. Team ERA for OU, excuse me, is 1.18. Teams hit 153 against Sooner pitching. 0-2 the count to Dominguez. The pitch, swinging a foul back, jammed her on a fastball. Right-handed batter, Kylie Naomi, and then the top of the order, Riley Bayless, here in the third inning. Cowgirls had only 1 infield hit last night, and that was a hit off the glove of the third baseman Romero by Springfield. If it had been baseball, they probably would have scored it an error. I thought OU was going to do it anyway to keep the no-hitter intact. Here's the pitch, and a fastball that just missed. Where was that one? And it's 1-2 strikes to Dominguez. Lopez has had a pretty good season. As we mentioned, just lost 1 game on the year. This is her 19th start. The pitch, swing, a line drive in the air. He is caught at behind first base. Out there by the second baseman on the run, Kaylee Clifton, for the out. Dominguez flies out to right field, a little short fly ball, but Clifton, who has good speed, ran it down for the first out. Brings up Kylie Naomi. She started and played in all 50 games this year for Oklahoma State as the shortstop. Showed off her arm a couple of times last night. Ran down a runner between first and second. And turned a double play today. First pitch to her has popped up. That's back our way. And out of play for strike one. 258, 5 homers and 14 runs batted in. Naomi out of Maurice, Louisiana, out of North Vermilion High School. Appreciate all the folks listening on the radio today, as well as the internet at stillwaterradio.net and okstate.com. The 1-0, or make it 0-1, is a popped-up bunt. It falls. They're going to let it roll foul. Sooners did the right thing there, as that ball did not stay in fair territory. It had just enough spin, about 15 feet of that off the line, or up the line, rather, at third base to go foul. Pitcher and the catcher and the third baseman all converged and said, let it go. Rise ball is not a real easy pitch to bunt. That pitch was hit up in the air a little bit. Next delivery, swinging a ball, hit down the line and left. I don't think they'll get to this one. It's foul and out of play. So it's 0-2 to Kylie Naomi. She has walked 25 times this year out of the number 9 spot, basically, in the order. She is 16 out of 18 in stolen bases. After they put that error up on the play where Bayless ended up going from second to third on the rundown last night, that took the stolen base for her off the board, so she is still 14 out of 16 on the season. But Naomi leads with 16. And with one out, she has an 0-2 count on her from Mariah Lopez. 4-0 Sooners here in the bottom of 3. Time is called now. Pitcher and catcher are confused about the signs. They have these wristbands, and Lopez looks down there in the circle and goes, what's this one? And the catcher says, what's this? Now the pitcher and catcher can break up the conversation as the home plate umpire, Terry Holt, comes out. They only give him about 15 to 20 seconds to break it up. We'll see if they're back on the right page. The 0-2 again, and a rise ball fastball high, and the count is 1-2. We still have folks coming in the ballpark, and again, we have 2 games today. This one's still to be completed, and the game at 3 o'clock, which was the regularly scheduled game. Now the 1-2 to Naomi. Fastball that just misses off the outside corner, and the count's 2-2. On deck is Riley Bayless for the Cowgirls, looking for their second base runner of the day. They have one hit and trail 4-0. Outfield straight away, not deep. Wind has died down here at the ballpark. Here's the pitch. Swain a ground ball to third. Romero will have it, double clutches, and throws to first for the out. Want to make sure she has the grip on the ball, and Naomi, who can fly down the line, is out 5-3. So two outs, and it brings up Riley Bayless, who struck out swinging her first time up. One of the four strikeout victims by Lopez in this game today. There have been 17 strikeouts by Cowgirl hitters, 13 last night and 4 today so far in this series. Time was called by the home plate umpire. Bayless stepped out. Signals are called, of course, by both these teams for the pitchers from the dugout. First pitch, check swing up and in, went around. That's a strike, and the count is 0-1. Pitch was up around her head. Count is 0-1 with two outs. Here in the third inning, the pitch. Fastball high. Cowgirls again will play at 11-5 on Friday in the Big 12 tournament down in Oklahoma City, sponsored by Phillips 66. No games on the main field this year because of all the construction. They're trying to get that all done before the College World Series in a month. The 1-1, low and away. So it's two balls and a strike. So games will be played on the field behind field number 1 and field number 2, which is the Integris field to the left of the main field. 2-1 pitch is popped up and caught on the move to her left by the third baseman Romero. That ball hit off the handle, and the pop-up ends the inning, and Bayless is the third out here in the third inning. Cowgirls go in order for the second straight inning, and after three, it's OU 4 and Oklahoma State nothing. This is the Bedlam Series and Cowgirl softball from Learfield IMG College. With a 4-0 lead over the Cowgirls. Trying to win for the 91st time in this series. They lead the series 90-71. Again, the Cowgirls, since the Big 12 era began in 1997, have only won 7 games in this series. They have not won at all since 2011, as the Sooners have dominated, winning 21 in a row. Reagan Rogers, their designated player, hitting for the pitcher spot, leads it off for Oklahoma. She will face Logan Simonek for the first time today. Rogers a 5-3 ground out against the starter Clakely back in the second inning. First pitch, hits her. Hit batsman, that's been a problem with Simonek this year. That's her 10th hit batsman, that's most on the team. The leadoff man's on 3 innings, or make that now 4 innings in a row for Oklahoma, and it brings up Lindsay Elam. She grounded out to the first baseman, unassisted, her first time up. She is the sophomore catcher. They start senior, 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 sophomore, freshman, junior, senior, sophomore, freshman, and the junior pitcher, Lopez. First pitch, a show bunt, everybody moving, but pitch was high for ball 1. So again, Baylor at Texas today, but that game now doesn't mean anything because with Baylor's loss last night to Texas, they cannot finish 6th in the league. Kansas has the tiebreaker even if they win today. They beat them 2 out of 3 up in Orocha Ballpark. The seeding is set for the Big 12 tournament. Here's the pitch high. It'll be OSU second, Oklahoma first, Texas, Texas Tech, Iowa State, and then Kansas. Baylor had a free fall this year. They are 18-30, is going to be on the outside looking in. And the reason is they lost 2 out of 3 to Kansas, assuming that Baylor beats Texas today. If not, Kansas is the outright winner anyway. Here's the pitch, and it's a strike. They show a bunt and look the runner back with nobody covering first, and the count is 2 balls and a strike. Chow and the third baseman, Pennington, crash in from first and third, respectively. Shortstop covers second. Second baseman supposed to cover the first base bag if the ball is put in play. See if Phelan's bunting here. The pitch, she is. Bunts it back to the pitcher. They get the runner at first. That's all they could do, as Rogers has great speed. 6 out of 6 on steals this year, and she's down to second on the sacrifice. It goes 1-3, and the Sooners now sacrificed 24 times this year. Cowgirls have done it, 19 times. So runner in scoring position with one out for Lyons, who had a single and scored a run her last time up ahead of Romero's 2-run homer, and she'll bat next. First pitch by the left or right-hander, Semenek, a strike, and the count is 0-1. Wind has picked up a little bit here again at the ballpark, moving the flag a little bit out there in left field, but not much. And a big crowd here for Bedlam today, as we expected, especially with a doubleheader, 2 games today. And the 0-1 from Semenek. Swing, and this is popped up behind first base. Second baseman goes out and makes the catch for the out, and the runner stays at second. On the outfield grass, the catch made by Montgomery, and that's the second out of the inning. Montgomery, by the way, 40 double plays she has helped turn this year, and that is a school record. That was set in the game with the Sooners last night. So around to Romero, who's walked and hit a 2-run homer and scored twice in this game. She's accounted for 3 of the 4 runs. 2 outs and a runner at second in the first pitch. That is in there for a strike on an off-speed delivery. That home run by Romero chased Clakely from the game. Semenek has pitched now to all the Sooner hitters in the lineup. 4-0 OU here in the fourth of game number one. Semenek back on the rubber, looks in and has the sign and comes home. Look out, spins her out of the way of a fastball. Now Clakely did that the last time, and Romero hit the next pitch out of the ballpark. The count is 1-1. Hit a foul ball down the line and left and got spun out of the way of a ball up and in, and then hit the next pitch out into the parking lot out there. The 1-1. Swing a ground ball to the pitcher. They'll throw her out. The inning's over. So they hit batsman in the sacrifice. The runner to second, but no farther, and the inning is over. Semenek's done well after giving up the walk and the double to Uview and Clifton back in the third inning. She has been effective, again allowing only one base runner since then, and that was in this inning. So no runs, no hits, and we had a sacrifice and one left. Halfway through this one, OU 4 and Oklahoma State nothing. Game one of our doubleheader, the second game coming up at 3 o'clock. This is Cowgirl Softball in the Bedlam Series from Learfield IMG College. As Mariah Lopez goes into the fourth inning, she's allowed only one hit, has struck out 4 for Oklahoma, and has not walked anybody. And she'll face Shaw, Montgomery, and Richburg in this fourth inning. Cowgirl bats need to get busy again. Again, only lost 3-0 last night. They're down 4-0 today, so they have not scored a run yet in this two-game series to this point. But they faced two of the better pitchers in the country, too, in Juarez last night and Lopez today. Xiao popped up to the catcher in front of the screen her first time up. And the first pitch here is down and in for ball one. A righty-righty matchup with Mariah Lopez. Going for her 17th win of the year. She's only lost one game. Cowgirls have one hit by Montgomery. She's on deck. The pitch. Xiao takes a fastball low, and it's 2-0. Lopez hasn't even been close to a walk yet in this game. 2-0 is about the deepest she's been. And has that now on Xiao. Outfield deep and straight away. Here's the 2-0. Taking, that's inside for ball three. Well, it just takes base runners, and then it takes a couple of hits, and you're right back in this thing. It's a 3-0 count. Xiao's way ahead, probably taking here. On the way, a fastball, and it's a strike, 3-1. They might turn her loose here. It's 4-0 OU. They scored a run in the first and 3 in the third. And again, we'll have game 2 coming up at 3 o'clock today. The Cowgirls and the Sooners, the regular season finale for both teams. 3-1 pitch. Strike inside corner, 3-2. Both teams are headed, obviously, to the Big 12 tournament as the 1, OU, and OSU, the 2 seeds. Could face each other in the finals next Saturday night. That would be fun. Cowgirls have missed out on that the last couple of years. They went to pool play. Here's the 3-2. Swinging a ball hit foul off the end of the bat and down the line and right and out of play. Bullpens are quiet for both teams as we check here left and right. In the bottom of the fourth, 4-0 OU, and we await the 3-2 pitch coming from Mariah Lopez to Samantha Xiao. And here it is. And a swing and a fly ball hit deep to right. That's going to leave the yard and up on the scoreboard. A home run over Xiao, and that gives her the all-time single-season record of 16. RBI number 47. And the Cowgirls score their first run of this series. It's 4-1. And for Lopez, she doesn't give up very many home runs. That's just her third she's given up all year. An opposite field shot about a third of the way up the scoreboard and right. Wasn't much question about it. 16 now. Xiao has the single season record. Montgomery had it last year at 15, and she's up at the plate now. So it's a three-run game again, and the second hit for Oklahoma State is the first extra base hit, I believe, of this series. That is correct. Yeah, the Sooners had five of them last night. Three doubles and two home runs. And they have a home run and a double today. First pitch to Montgomery, swing and a miss for strike one. 231 games started for her. And again, she's on the verge of becoming the first non-Sooner to get 200 RBIs in a career in this league. Here's a swing and a miss down and away for strike two. Games started and played in a row. That's three away from the record also. The pitch, that's high. Romero continues to add to her numbers, and she has two more today to give her 209. Shelby Penley, fourth. Jessica Schultz, third. Samantha Ricketts, second. And Lauren Chamberlain, first. Montgomery at 199. Join that group with 200. The pitch just misses outside, 2-2. Young lady from Baylor also has a chance, but she would have to go deep into the, well, it's not going to happen now because I'm not going to get enough RBIs unless Freudenberg gets a big game today to be able to get into that record. The pitch, 2-2 is high. It's 3-2. Baylor's going to miss the postseason for the first time in a while. They have struggled this year, but they'll be back next year without injuries and with great young players. There's a swing and a miss and a strikeout on a pitch up and away, and Montgomery is the fifth strikeout victim of the day for Lopez. So after giving up the home run to Schau, Montgomery strikes out, and here's Richburg, a strikeout victim her first time up. It's the most folks we've had in the outfield all year. They go from one foul pole to the other, left to right. Always a big group out there in left and left center, but today, right center and right. The pitch, inside and low, ball one to Richburg. Underway here in the fourth inning with a home run and a strikeout. Cowgirls are on the board at 4-1 here in the bottom of four. A great afternoon for softball here in town. Cowboy baseball team is on the road. The pitch and a fastball for a strike. I want to credit the Stillwater High School baseball team as they came back and beat Enid yesterday, and so they're in the if game tomorrow in the regional final at Couch Park just down the road from here, and a win there and you're in the state tournament. So good luck to the Pioneers of Jimmy Harris tomorrow. That game at 4 o'clock. Here's the 1-1, a swing and a foul back. That pitch was up and it's strike two. Richburg last night was at the plate with the bases loaded, but struck out against Juarez. Tough spot for a sophomore against a veteran pitcher. Next pitch is swung on. This is popped up over by first base. Maybe a play, but no, it's on top of the camera deck over there on the top of the first base dugout. Wind has picked up again here a little bit, blowing the flag almost straight out there in left field. Schau hit that against the wind, 90-degree angle, and didn't have any reason to think that ball wasn't going to go out to right and out of the ballpark, which it did. The wind blows out toward left. The pitch inside, missed the corner, and it's 2-2. On deck for the Cowgirls is Cheyenne Factor. Lopez checks the signals and gets it, and the pitch. Swing and a miss, struck her out on a fastball. That is the second out of the inning. And so that brings up Factor. That's a sixth strikeout for Lopez in the ballgame. Factor was a strikeout victim her first time up. She'll stand in there with two outs. First pitch. Upstairs for ball one. Talked about the fact that was only the third home run given up by Lopez. They've given up 20 now as a team and have hit 95 counting today. The 1-0, swing and a foul. That's off the handle and back to the screen. So it's a ball and a strike to Factor. And again, her brother's baseball team, Oklahoma State, playing at 2 o'clock today out at Oregon State, trying for the sweep. It'll be a 1:30 dugout show on Hot 93.7. So check that out today in between games of our doubleheader here. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a ball lifted well into center. That carries back toward the track and it is caught nearly up against the wall by the center fielder, Mendez, who ended up against the wall. She ran that ball down, looked like it might leave the ballpark, but just missed being out of here as it was caught in the warning track by the center fielder Mendez, who ran it down, and the inning is over. So Factor hit a ball a long ways to the deepest part of the ballpark, but Mendez, who's a good center fielder, ran it down, and that ends the inning. Mendez has not made an error, I don't think, this year. No, she hasn't. That makes a good play there to rob the Cowgirls of an extra base hit. So a run in the inning on the home run by Schau, and nobody left on base. So the Cowgirls now trail 4-1 after four, and this is the Bedlam Series and Cowgirl softball from Learfield, IMG College. Oh! State, a couple of them actually. Riley Bayless moves from left field to right field, and the new left fielder is going to be Chelsea Alexander, who played in the game last night down in Norman. And Michaela Richburg will be out of the game, at least for the moment, as Schau stays at first base. And the hitter will be Uvue, the left-handed batting left fielder. Walked and scored and singled today. Walked off of Semenecker first time up, or last time up, and hits this one foul back to the left and out of play, and it's strike one. She has an on-base percentage over 500 now with the two on-bases today. Walking a single count toward that on-base percentage, obviously. Semenek's next pitch is a fastball, and that is low, and it's count of 1-1. A few Clifton and Hollow in this inning, and it seemed like they bat every inning. Sooners have won 36 in a row, 41 straight in the conference, going back more than 2 years. They are the eighth straight conference champion in the Big 12 in the regular season. A pitch low here for a ball, 2-1. And they've won 16 of the conference championships that have been won since 1997. How many would that be? 23, right? I just about guessed the others. Nebraska, Baylor, Texas A&M, and maybe Missouri. I think that's right. Here's a pitch that just misses inside. The fans now, at least the Cowgirl fans, all over the home plate umpire, Terry Holt. 3-1 the count. The leadoff man's been on for them every inning. We're in the fifth, 4-1 Sooners. The pitch. That's high for ball four, and the streak continues. That's the fourth walk given to the Sooners today. If you start giving them free passes, they start hitting the baseball, or the softball in this case, around. Clifton up now and bunts for a squeeze play, single, or actually she was out. And the run scored back in the first, and then doubled in a run in the third. Sooners have scored in the first and third, so the odd-numbered innings have been good for them today in a 4-1 lead. First pitch. Inside, backs her away, it's ball one. In our second, our second game will go at 3 o'clock with a 2:45 pregame show, so we're liable to have some time here between the two games. And we will fill that with music back at our local affiliate there, Stillwater Radio, KGFY. Pitch is high, 2 balls and no strikes. Wind now blowing more out towards center field than it was a little bit ago, moving the flag out there in left center. Fans enjoying the day, a lot of them working on their suntans today. The pitch, off-speed delivery, that's in for a strike, and it's 2-1 from Logan Semenek. Gabby Sprang still warming up in the bullpen for Oklahoma State. Sooner bullpen. And they got a right-hander down there loose. I'm not sure. We'll find out who that is here in a moment. Pitch hit on to the third baseman. They'll go to second for one on the first. The throw is high, and it'll be a fielder's choice. They'll get the lead runner, though. That ball came up quickly for the third baseman, Pennington, on a one-hopper. She was able to turn it to second. The throw there was high, and that forced a high throw from the shortstop. So fielder's choice. Lead runner's cut down. Uvue is out. Clifton's on at first, and here's Alo, who has a strikeout and a walk today. She stands in, a right-handed batter. First pitch, taking a fastball strike on the inside corner, and the count is 0-1. So the bullpen's busy for both teams here in inning number five. The pitch, swinging a ground ball to the right side. That's a base hit. It missed hitting the fielder, or the runner, I should say, and the right fielder getting it back in Bayless. So a solid single to the opposite field by Alo as her first hit today. And here's Grace Green with two on and one out. The Sooners start getting this hitting momentum, they just keep coming at you. They did it piece by piece last night in a 3-0 win. Getting two in the fourth on back-to-back home runs and then getting the back-to-back doubles to score the run in the sixth. Green is grounded out and hit into a double play. First pitch, swing and a miss. Threw it by her, strike one on a high fastball. So the count is 0-1. And the Cowgirls trying to, at worst, salvage a split today if they can and win a game in this series for the first time in 8 years. Here's the 0-1, swing and a pop-up behind second. Montgomery over there to her right makes the catch for the out. So Green pops up, and that's the second out of the inning. Cowgirls nearly turned their fourth double play in this inning earlier of this series. Mendez up now has struck out and grounded out. Actually, she has struck out and has a hit today, and they may run down at first base. Or they might pinch hit. That's what they're going to do. They're going to pinch hit Sammy Skelly, who's a freshman from Lone Grove, Oklahoma, down by Ardmore. She did not play in the game last night. Skelly hitting .353. This is her 23rd game. Six hits and 17 trips. And three runs scored. She has two homers and nine runs batted in and has a double. So all three, well, three of her six hits, I should say, are extra base hits. She'll hit for Mendez, who can then re-enter the game. So you have runners at first and second with two outs. Hollow down at first and Clifton down at second. And the Sooners trying to catch fire again here and break the game open. Leading 4-1, first pitch. Strike at the letters, and the count is 0-1 to the pinch hitter. Name like Skelly, being from Oklahoma, you wonder if she's related to the Oil family. Here's the 0-1 and a fastball inside. Missing low, 1-1. Skelly, a right-handed batter. The mention has some power. There are two outs in the inning. Simonek has pitched around trouble and each of her last two innings. Here's a pitch for a strike, an off-speed delivery, and it's 1-2. So she's trying to finish the point to do the same thing again in this inning. Designated player Reagan Rogers is on deck. Sooners lead 4-1 here in the fifth, here in Stillwater, game number one of our doubleheader. The 1-2 from Simonek, way outside. Dominguez has to backhand that from going to the screen. So it's an even count, two balls and two strikes. Cowgirls will have Lynch, Pennington, and Dominguez to bat in the fifth. And they'll trail by at least three. Here's the 2-2 from Simonek. Swing and a ball hit up the middle. Shortstop has it. Will step on second. The inning is over. So another play by Naomi to rob a batter of a hit. And it's a six unassisted, and the Sooners leave a couple. They've left five now in the ballgame. No runs, one hit, a walk, a fielder's choice, and two left. So we go to the bottom of five, 4-1 OU. This is Cowgirl Softball and the Bedlam Series from Learfield IMG College. As we get ready for the bottom of the fifth inning, four runs, six hits, no errors for OU. They've left five. They've lost a couple runners on the bases, one on a double play today. And for the Cowgirls, one run, two hits, and no errors. The only run, a home run by Samantha Shaw in the last inning. The other hit was by Maddie Sue Montgomery in the first inning. And they've left one base runner in the game. Taylor Lynch grounded out to the shortstop her first time up. Cowgirls had a number of people this week make the all-academic Big 12 team, which we'll mention here in just a moment. Here's the first pitch from Lopez, a swing and a foul back. And that's strike one. First team, Chelsea Alexander, Lauren Heinzelman, who had a 4.0 average, Elise LaBeouf, one of the co-captains, Taylor Lynch is on that group, Maddie Sue Montgomery, Sydney Pennington, Michaela Richburg, and then Mallory Goodman and Riley Bayless make the second team, all-academic, all-Big 12. The pitch, that's high. The full team, the regular team with the offensive and defensive and pitching stars of the year, will be announced by the Big 12 as the tournament starts Friday. That'll be at a banquet and ceremony on Thursday night that the teams will attend. One ball and one strike. Lopez pitched to Lynch. Is swung on and hit down the line and left. That'll curve into the bullpen and foul ball, and it's a count of one and two. We will talk with some folks from the LSU Alumni Association, by the way, during the second inning of our second game this afternoon. So be aware of that, and you get the latest lowdown. We'll have them for a whole inning there at the top of the second, and we'll talk about what's going on with the LSU Alumni Association. The 1-2, swing and a foul. That was off the screen over the third base dugout, and the count one ball and two strikes. They play Lynch to go the other way to left field, being a left-handed hitter. They give her right center. Although the right fielder, about in the middle between center and right, give her the right field corner, too. And not deep in the outfield. The pitch, swing, a pop-up that hit the top of the screen. Almost got back our way, and the count's still 1-2 to Lynch. Pennington and then Dominguez in this inning for the Cowgirls, and they trail 4-1. Here in the bottom of five, this is game one of our doubleheader. We'll have our second game coming up in a couple of hours here at 3 o'clock. Mariah Lopez, six strikeouts today. Excuse me, has not walked anyone. The 1-2, swinging a ground ball. First baseman has it, and we'll play it to the bag for the out. Three unassisted, and Lynch is retired. It'll bring up Sydney Pennington, who also struck out her first time up. I didn't read this last night, so I'll read it now. This is a copyright broadcast, exclusive presentation of Learfield IMG College under broadcasting rights granted by Oklahoma State. For use and presentation is prohibited without the expressed written consent of OSU and Learfield IMG College. First pitch, swing and a miss, strike one by Pennington on a rise ball. Announcers are provided by Learfield IMG College and approved by Oklahoma State University. 0-1 the count to Pennington out of Sand Springs, out of Charles Page High School. The pitch, fastball high. Sand Springs has one of the best pizza places in the world, and they have one in Broken Arrow now. It's called Minuteman. If you've never been there, you've missed it. But it's really good. 1-1 the count. 4-6-0 for the Sooners, 1-2-0 for the Cowgirls. The pitch in the dirt and off the catcher. Two balls and a strike. Bullpen's now quiet for both teams again. Sydney Pennington sitting on 9 home runs. 10 would give the Cowgirls 3 in double figures in a season for the first time in school history. The 2-1, swing and a miss. Upstairs rise ball again. And it starts out around your waist, and then all of a sudden it just is where you're thinking it's going to be, and it's not. And the count's 2-2. On deck is Raquel Dominguez, except we have a pinch hitter down there now, Elise LaBeouf. The 2-2. Strike three at the letters, a fastball. And caught looking for the 7th strike out of the game. And here's LaBeouf, who's going to get a chance to bat. Elise is one of the co-captains, along with Shaw and Pennington, who just batted. 133 average. She's played in 16 games this year. She's 2 out of 15 with 3 runs scored. Two hits, one of them is a double. And she has 1 run batted in. LaBeouf is out of Crowley, Louisiana, transferred to OSU. She's a senior this year out of the University of Houston.
And for the Cowgirls,
They named three captains this year. And actually named two and then picked a third. Clifton is the captain for OU. The Cowgirls have not had captains in quite a while on a team. Kenny Gajewski said, sure, we'll do that. Players got together and voted in not one, not two, but three. First pitch, swing and a miss for strike one. In our second game, coming up at 3 o'clock or shortly thereafter, we'll be on the air at 2:45 or so with the pregame show. It's almost like a day-night doubleheader today. But it's not, an 0-1, and that is low and away for a ball, and it's 1-1 to the left-handed batter, Elise LeBeouf. Spells her name L-E-B-E-O-U-F. She's from Cajun country, Crowley, Louisiana. 1-1, swing and a miss. That ball up and in, strike two. Just getting underway is Texas and Baylor. We'll give you score updates on that and the Texas Tech-Kentucky game as we get farther into the afternoon. Excuse me, again, the pairings are set for the Big 12 tournament, so the scores of those games really don't mean anything except for postseason beyond the Big 12. Here's a pop-up, and the second baseman on the edge of the grass makes the catch, Clifton, and the inning is over, and the Cowgirls go quietly for the third inning and five so far in this game. Up and down in order is Oklahoma State, and after five, it's the Sooners four and the Cowgirls one. This is the Bedlam Series and Cowgirl softball from Learfield IMG College. Inning and Oklahoma State trails OU by the score of 4-1. Sooners trying to win this series again, as they have won every series since 2011 in this three and sometimes four game set. Used to be home and home in a neutral site. They got rid of that a few years ago and went to 2-1 and 2-0 Norman last year and 2-0 Stillwater this year. Reagan Rogers leads it off, and the first pitch to her is strike one. Hit by a pitch and grounded out in her two times at the plate today. Hit by a pitch by Semenek in her last at-bat. Logan in relief here of the starter, Samantha Clakely, who did not finish the third inning. Now the 0-1 and a fastball low and the count of ball and a strike. Rogers, Elam, and Lyons at the bottom of the order here for the Sooners. We're trying to win their 17th conference game of the season and their 47th of the year. Game number 49 for them, number 50 for Oklahoma State. The 1-1, swing and a pop-up in front of the plate. Catcher comes out and makes the catch for the out. That's Dominguez who's catching today for Oklahoma State, one down. It's not an easy play out in front of the plate with that glove having to go up and backwards, and you still have to be able to see the ball. We may have a pinch hitter here for Elam. We did last night, and we'll hear today. Kylie Lundberg, the senior left-hander out of Lakewood, California, pinch hit for Mendez last night, and she will pinch hit for Elam, who can then re-enter the game as the catcher. Lundberg, left-handed batter with some power, 273 average. She's not started the game this year, but played in 27 for OU. Has a homer and five runs batted in. First pitch from Semenek, foul back to the screen, strike one. Again, if you've just joined us and wondering, is this the 3 o'clock game? No. We're making up Friday's rainout here, started at 11:30. So we'll have a game at 3 as well. Next pitch is high for a ball, 1-1. We could have an hour to an hour and a half between games here, so plenty of time to get some lunch and come on out to the ballpark. Again, you can get in. Standing room only tickets are available. The pitch. That's a floater. It's in there for a strike. And the count is 0-2. Make it 1-2 to the hitter, and it's a pinch hitter, Lundberg. Lundberg went 0-1 last night, the pitch. Fastball low. As a pinch hitter, she hit again, as I said, for Mendez. Sooners looking for their seventh hit. 2-2 count with one out here in the sixth. Cowgirls are running out of outs again here in this ballgame. The 2-2 on the way. Swing, a line drive to center, and that is over the head of the shortstop. That's a base hit. So a pinch hit single for Lundberg, and that's the seventh hit for OU, and it brings up Grace Lyons, their shortstop. Patty Gasso might pinch hit here. Now Lyons is coming to the plate, so they may run down at first base, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Is down there when we get a chance. Then Elam can still re-enter the game as a catcher. It is Audrey LaValle out of Choctaw, played at Carl Albert High School, so a Lady Titan freshman. She'll run down at first base. Lyons has a hit and a run score today. She's 1-for-2 at the bottom of the order. First pitch, swing, a ball off the third baseman. That'll be into left field. That'll be a base hit. And the Sooners have two on with one out. A hard shot off the third baseman's glove. Playing off the bag was Pennington down there at third, and she nearly got clobbered by that ball. It went off her glove in the air into left field. So here's the top of the order, and Romero is up. Grounded out, two-run homer, walk, and two-run score. Eight hits now for OU. First pitch. Show bunt, that's a strike right down the middle. Scenario is different with runners at first and second. The corner fielders crash. The shortstop covers third. Instead of going to second, obviously, to try to get the lead runner. Outfield deep and straight away against the nominee for Player of the Year nationally. Here's the 0-1, and a fastball is just low. One ball, one strike to Romero. Out of Vista Murrieta High School in San Diego, California. Semenek has to pitch out of a jam again. She's had two every inning. The pitch. Down and in for a ball, and it's now 2-1. Well, if you load the bases, then you bring up Hovview, and then Clifton, and who knows who else will bat in this inning. So you set yourself up for trouble. Cowgirls could use another double play. Here's the pitch. Swing and a ball hit the center. That's a line drive, and it's off the ground for a base hit. They'll throw to third, and actually coming back into second with the throw, and the lead runner ends up at third. And that's LaValle, who's down there now with still only one out, and then single to center by Romero. Gives them nine hits now in the game, and it brings up of you with the bases loaded. She has singled and walked twice and scored a run. They might put a play on here as they did earlier in the game with Clifton. First pitch, taking it is low for ball one. Sprang is back up in the bullpen for Oklahoma State. You hear the Sooner crowd urging on OU. Outfield deep and straight away. Hovview has seven home runs. The pitch, swing, and a pop-up. That's going to, I think, make the seats, and it will over here, and a good catch by a Cowgirl fan over here by the third base dugout. One ball, one strike. Cowgirl record at home, by the way, 16, or make it 15-1. on the season. The 1-1 from Semenuk. Swing, a line drive, base hit to center. That will score two. Lead runner, second runner coming around. The throw back in. It's a single and a two RBI hit for Abiu, who is 2-for-2 with two walks, a run scored, and two RBIs. And the lead goes to 6-1 on the 10th hit of the night by the Sooners. That was a line drive right back up over second base to the left of the bag, and no chance for anybody to make a play on that one. Here's Jeff Cottrell coming out of the dugout for the Cowgirls, the pitching coach. He'll have a word with Semenuk while the Sooner players gather around Patty Gasso down the third base line. Once again, the Sooner bats today have been busy. They were busy some yesterday, but again, with Juarez, you don't need very many runs, and apparently today you don't either with the pitcher Lopez. It's a 5-run game, and they're threatening to make it even more than that. Cottrell has finished, with his conversation. Girl with us at the beginning of the game. I'm battling a cold again today for the second day in a row, and doing the best I can here, but I don't feel bad. It's just I've got a head cold. Everybody's had that before, and if you have to talk for a living, it sucks, but we're getting through it. So now here's Clifton, and she could make it a run rule game here. Fielder's choice, an RBI double, and a squeeze play bunt for an RBI back in the first. Clifton has 43 runs batted in and takes an off-speed pitch for a strike at the letters, and the count is 0-1. Sprang is still throwing in the Cowgirl bullpen. Kenny Gajewski just walked down there to check on her. I can see him coming back to the dugout. Clifton, the captain for OU, their senior, the pitch. And that one hit a mile and foul down the left field line and a rocket shot that she swung so hard. You know those little wristband things they have? Whatever she had in her pockets, they change out those cards and those wristbands. She swung so hard, those popped out of her pockets, or her hip pockets. Everybody in one piece again, and it's 0-2. First and second, one out. Sooners lead 6-1. The pitch up and in. Baseball's this way. Softball's this way to a point. Not a lot of pitchers pitch inside, and there's a difference between throwing inside and pitching inside. The 1-2 swing, and this ball's popped up to the pitcher, and they'll look the runners back for the out. Clifton got a spinner off the handle and popped it up in the circle to Semenuk, who makes the play. And that's the second out of the inning. Now Alo will bat. She has walked and singled and has struck out looking, and she doesn't strike out very often. Just 12 times this year in 133 at-bats. And she could make it a run rule game at this point. Sitting on 13 home runs. First pitch, missing inside, ball one. Right-handed batter out of Hawaii. Great freshman year a year ago for the Sooners. So now first and second, the infield back with two outs. The pitch, swing the ground ball to the first baseman. And Chow will take it to the bag, and that'll be the inning. Damage done, two runs in the inning on four hits for the Sooners. Two RBI single by by Abiu was the top hit of the inning, and they leave a couple. They've left seven for the ballgame. The bottom of 6-1 OU. This is the Bedlam Series and Cowgirl Softball from Learfield, IMG College.
Show. Be sure to tune in and find out where the Cowgirls are headed for the postseason.
Texas and Baylor in a meaningless game is scoreless. That game is in the second inning. And Texas Tech is playing Kentucky today, and they are scoreless in the second inning also out in Lubbock. Again, that's a regular season finale for them today as they finished conference play last week being swept by the Cowgirls. Ryan Lopez still in the circle for OU as we bat here in the bottom of the sixth. Oklahoma State with a deficit of five. It's a 6-1 game. And Kylie Naomi, the shortstop, who showed off her arm and defensive prowess a couple of times last night and again today, is at the plate. A 5-3 ground out, her first time up, first pitch. Swing, a rip, foul, look out. Deep in the bullpen down there, out of play, left side, strike one. Bayless and then Shaw will bat in this inning for Oklahoma State. Naomi in there and ran the next pitch from Lopez. A swing and a miss on a rise ball is up and away. Strike two. And we'll probably have about an hour and a half, maybe a little less than that, between games. And that is by design, as again, the regular game is at 3 o'clock today. The 0-2, way high and almost back to the screen. Cowgirls have been held to two hits. Shaw has a home run, setting the school record for single-season home runs at 16. And then Montgomery had a two-out single in the first. That's it off of Lopez. She has struck out seven. The pitch, way high again, 2-2. Kansas and Iowa State played a doubleheader yesterday, and Kansas lost both ends, but they're still going to make the Big 12 tournament. 2-2 the count. They're going to be the number six seed. The pitch, swing, a ball off the plate is fair at third and out at first, as coming in was the third baseman to make the play, Romero, right next to the line at fair ground for the out. So Naomi is retired 5-3, and here is Bayless, who's 0-2 with a pop-up and a strikeout. She has had trouble with that rise ball today by Lopez. Cowgirls, with the loss last night by shutout, have been shut out the last three games in Norman. Lost here last year, 3-2. First pitch is a strike on the outside corner at the knees to Bayless, and the count is 0-1. And they're trailing 6-1 here today. They've not won in this series since 2011. 0-1 to count the pitch. That's a high fastball, and it's 1-1. The only way Kansas can make the NCAA tournament is to win the Big 12, and that's not likely. However, there could be five teams from the league end up in the tournament. Depends on what Tech and Iowa State do. The pitch, swinging a foul back. Tech is 37-13. I think their resume is good enough to make the tournament now. The bubble team is Iowa State, whose RPI is not bad at 56. 31-22 after wins this weekend against Kansas, sweeping that series. The pitch, low and away. We saw Iowa State early in the year. They're a feisty bunch. They hit the ball well. But what's going to kill them if they don't make the tournament is the fact they're 1-12 against the top 25. The 2-2. Swing and a miss and a strikeout. Bayless chased that rise ball again. Second time she struck out today, and that's eight who have struck out today and 21 in this series by the Cowgirls. Two outs for Samantha Shaw, who hit one off the scoreboard and right for a home run her last time up against Lopez, who's only given up three home runs all year. So there's a chance the Big 12 could get five teams in the tournament, but we'll see. First pitch. Pass ball to Shaw is a strike. I think Tech gets in. I don't know if they deserve to get in, but they'll get in as a four seed probably. Texas and Oklahoma State and OU will probably host. Texas might not, but I think they will. They're 40-12. The pitch, swing, and a ball hit into left in the air. Should be caught, and it is for the out by the left fielder of you, and the inning is over. And again, the Cowgirls go quietly against Mariah Lopez. But the seventh inning, the Sooners lead 6-1. This is the Bedlam Series in Cowgirl Softball from Learfield IMG College. Sooners have a 6-1 lead here in game one of our doubleheader. And we'll have part of our Bob Kingsley countdown coming up between games, and then we'll have game two coming up at 2:45 this afternoon. Logan Simonek into our fourth inning of work here. He's already pitched part of the third, fourth, fifth, sixth. This will be our fifth inning of work. He has given up runners in each of the innings. He's given up, let's see here, three of the six runs today. The other three were charged to the starter, Samantha Clakely, who's on line for the loss if it stays like it is. Here's Grace Green to lead it off, and the first pitch to her is hit foul down the right side and out of play for strike one. Elam, by the way, re-entered the game as the catcher. I failed to say that in the last defensive inning for the Sooners. Sooners will bat Green, and then the spot that Mendez had, who I think also re-entered the game, and then Rogers, the designated player. We'll have senior day ceremonies here also. So stay here for that if you're coming to the second game. Here's the 0-1, a swing and a rip past third. That's foul, out of play into the corner. That pitch was up, and it's 0-2. Bullpens are quiet for both teams here as the Sooners three outs away from their 37th straight win and their 42nd straight in conference play going back more than 2 years. Green, a right-handed batter, is grounded out, popped up, and hit into a double play and takes a ball high here, and it's a ball and two strikes. Green out of Oakdale, California, part of that California pipeline. They have it OU. Don't knock it till you've tried it. It's resulted in some All-American players. Here's the 1-2, and it's low. The list is 40-some deep, maybe longer than that, that I can think of off the top of my head. Patty Gasso in 25 years as the head coach. The pitch from 7X, swinging a fly ball hit into short right. Who's going to get it? Bayless for the out in right field. She called off Montgomery, and the play straight in front of her. She was able to make the catch, one down. That's the first time today, actually it's the second time today, because the last inning they didn't get the leadoff man on either, that the leadoff man has not been on to start the inning. So Green flies out to right. And it brings up Mendez, who re-entered the game earlier as the center fielder and goes back to hit here, and the first pitch to her is low for ball one. Would think for the Sooners it'll be Juarez in game two, but we'll see. Shaw is the likely starter for the Cowgirls, but they could turn around and bring Clakely back. She didn't pitch all that long today. Pitch is fouled off. I imagine they would give, Shaw one more chance here to throw in this series. So we might see both starters from last night, and we might not on less day rest, as again, this is a Saturday doubleheader Sunday series now, as opposed to Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Where you get an extra day off, you're not getting that, or not an extra day off, but an extra day off from pitching. You don't have that now, obviously, with playing last night and not playing on Friday. Mendez, a left-handed batter, the 1-1. She bunts, and it's almost caught, and the ball just past the catcher in the air and back to the screen. Boy, Dominguez jumped out of there to her left in a hurry and almost caught the ball. You don't ever see that, but she had good reflexes and saw the ball immediately off the bat. And again, nearly dove to her left and caught the ball in the air. It was just beyond her reach, strike two. Cowgirl team should be hosting a regional this year. Their record is good enough and all the other amenities around that. Here's the 1-2, swing the ground ball off the plate. Shortstop near the bag has it, and safe at first base. She beat it out. Good call by the umpire down there at first, Brian Crochet, as again, it was Mendez speed out of that left-handed batter's box with a high hopper in between hops fielded by Naomi. She had to kind of wait for the ball to come down a little bit, and it's an infield single. Reagan Rogers is the scheduled hitter, but we're going to have a pinch hitter as Elijah Flores is going to be the hitter. Aaliyah Flores, they say here. So Aaliyah Flores is the hitter. She's a right-hander, 5'2" sophomore, played last year as a freshman out of Colton, California. Flores' name sounds familiar. Yeah, that's her sister. Rogers was hit by a pitch, grounded out, and popped up. Excuse me. So for now, Flores will take over as the designated player. Had a first pitch in there for a strike. The count is 0-1. Excuse me. 11 hits now with that infield single by Mendez a moment ago. She runs at first with one out. Right-handed batter, the pitch is hit into center field, and that's a base hit by the pinch hitter. And Flores is on at first base. So that's the second time today they've had a pinch hit single. That'll bring up Elam, who re-entered the game as the catcher after Lundberg got a pinch hit single hitting for her in her last at bat. Didn't mention Flores, she hit .245 coming into that at bat, has 6 runs batted in and 5 doubles on the year, among her now 13 hits. First pitch here to Elam, who has a sack bunt today and also has a ground ball out, takes a ball high for 1. So again, multiple base runners for the Sooners again today in this inning. And they've done it every inning but 2 in this game today. We're in the 7th. The pitch up and in, backs her away from 2. So 3-0 last night in Norman. It's 6-1 here today. 12 hits now for OU, and 2 on with only 1 out. Elam, catcher at the plate, the pitch from Simonek. They'll throw to third, and the runner is safe at third base. They bounced the ball up there, and she nearly ran into the tag with the shortstop covering on the play for the Cowgirls. It'll end up being a double steal for Oklahoma. Pitch in the dirt was 3. So a steal by Mendez. She ends up at third, and Flores takes second on the throw. And the Sooners have 42 stolen bases now. The 3-0 pitch. That ball's hit off the handle toward the pitcher. They'll go to first and almost drop the ball. Side Samantha Shaw makes the catch. And did they call that a foul ball? Batter's coming back as if they did. That should be the right call also by the home plate umpire Terry Holt. So they tell Elam to come back, and it's 3-1. So she'll stand back in, the right-handed batter. You don't want to roll this lineup back to the top again. Second and third, first base open. 3-1's hit to the right side. That'll score a run. 4-3 on the ground out. And the other runner to third, as scoring is Mendez on an RBI ground out by Elam, and that'll give her her 24th of the year, and the Sooners pad the lead at 7-1. And that's the second out of the inning, and it brings up Lyons, who has 2 hits today, a pop-up and a run scored. Seven to one the score. The pitch is a fastball strike on the outside corner, and the count is 0-1. So the inning started with Green flying to right, and then we had 2 hits, a double steal, and a 4-3 groundout. Sooners about hit them 12-2 and lead 7-1 here in the 7th. The next pitch on the ground, foul to the left side. Coach Gasso had to get out of the way of that one, and it's a strike, 0-2. You want to get Lyons out here because you don't want to face Romero again. She will be on deck. Runner at third with 2 outs. They play him deep and straight away in the outfield. Lyons with 2 hits today from the shortstop position. The pitch. Look out, hit her on the ankle. Another hit batsman for Simonek. That ball down and in just got away from her, and the bases are loaded for Sydney Romero, and you don't want to face her in this situation. Two-run homer, a walk, a single, a ground out, and two runs scored and two runs batted in. Excuse me, first and third with two outs.
Now letting Rogue Wall on the third baseman, number two, Sydney.
Get a nominee for National Player of the Year, Romero out of San Diego. And she could make this a big lead here for the Sooners. It's already pretty good size. It's 6-7-1. Runners at the corners with two outs. Semenek has to bear down now to get a very tough hitter batting over 430. First pitch. Swing, a rip foul past third into the corner. That'll go out of play. Strike one. Again, we'll have a break between games probably a little more than an hour, and then we'll have game two coming up at 3 o'clock, a little after that, with our pregame show at 2:45. Strike one, the count with two outs here in the top of the seventh. Sooners lead 7-1. Semenek looks in and fires, and a fastball is high and away. It's one ball, one strike. Cowgirls, by the way, will have the heart of the order up. Montgomery, the spot where Richburg was. Alexander is there now, and then Cheyenne Factor. There could be a pinch hitter. We shall see. One ball, one strike with two outs. Pitch from Semenek. Swinging a foul, look out off the end of the bat. Nearly got the player in the on-deck circle down there. Of you at the first base dugout. So it's one ball, two strikes. Two hits and a hit batsman and a double steal. And a ground ball out for an RBI has resulted in a run here for the Sooners in this inning. So far, first and third, two outs. 7X, 1-2 to Romero. Swing, a ball up the middle, fielded by Montgomery. A backhand toss out of the glove to the shortstop, and the inning is over. Force out, play goes 4-6, and that ball headed for center field would have resulted in another run for the Sooners. Sooners get a run in the inning on two hits, a ground out for an RBI hit batsman, and they leave two. They've left nine in the ball game. Last ups here for the Cowgirls. They trail 7-1 here against Oklahoma. This is Cowgirl Softball in the Bedlam Series from Learfield IMG College. State as the Cowgirls with a 7-1 deficit here in the ball game. Mariah Lopez trying for her eighth complete game of the year, her 17th win of the year. Trying to see if the Sooners have made a substitution here, and they may have. Maddie Sue Montgomery will be the leadoff hitter for the Cowgirls. And she has a hit and a strikeout today. Again, her next RBI will be her 200th as a Cowgirl. And she'll be in an exclusive club. As she will be one of six players to have done that in Big 12 history, and the only others are from Oklahoma. She leads it off here. 3, 4, and 5 will bat here in this seventh inning. It's a 7-1 game, and the first pitch low and away from Lopez for ball one. And we'll have our usual post-game show, and then we'll take about an hour off here, and then we'll come back at 2:45 and play game number two. Lopez has struck out 8 today. The pitch, low and away. So it's 2-0 to Montgomery. The Cowgirls have been out hit 12-2 and lead, or trail rather, 7-1. Have not won a game in this series since 2011. Now have a chance for redemption either in this inning or in game number two. Here's the pitch. Swing and a pop-up. That's back our way to the left and out of play. Big crowd here, and there's room for you for game number two. Standing room only tickets are available. Come on out to the ballpark. Final regular season game coming up at 3 o'clock. 2-1 pitch, swinging a foul back. That again was a pitch off the outside corner. Excuse me, and the count is even at 2-2. Sun shining brightly through what cloud cover we have here at the ballpark. Temperature in the mid-70s. The 2-2 pitch, swing, and a ball hit in the air to left center, and that's going to chase back toward the track, and it's run down again on a basket catch by Mendez in center field for the out. She ran one down off the bat of Factor earlier in the game to the right of the hitter's backdrop. This one out near the flagpole and on the track in left field, and Montgomery gave that a ride, but just short. Alexander bats in Richburg's spot. She came in the game to play left field. And she is up there now for the first time today. Chelsea 0 for 1 officially last night in the game. First pitch in there for a strike, and the count is 0-1. So the Sooners have showed off the glove out there in center field with Mendez today as well. Count is 0-1. Lopez looks in, has the sign, and fires, and a fastball, and that is outside. One ball, one strike. Again, in the second inning of our second game today, we will talk with some folks from the OSU Alumni Association, so stay tuned for that. In our second game today, we'll have some interesting talk about what they're up to. Here's the 1-1. Fastball is high, two balls and a strike. Chelsea Alexander out of Ada, Oklahoma, played her high school ball at Latta down in southeastern Oklahoma. Very good softball, baseball school. They don't play football down there. Here's the 2-1. Another fastball, and that's under the zone. And the count is 3-1. 321 hitter Alexander with a homer and five runs batted in. She has three extra base hits, one of each of the variety. You can do that on the season. Wind again blowing out toward left. The pitch. Swing, a ball hit that way. It is caught near the line for the out. A line drive. And Uview is a good defensive left fielder, makes the play. Well, that was a loud out. Two down, and it brings up Factor as the last chance for the Cowgirls. Unless they elect to pitch hit here, which they might. But I see Factor standing there. I say that now, and she heads back to the dugout, and we're going to see Lauren Heintzelman hit. Redshirt senior out of South Lake, Texas, transferred here from Virginia. And Lauren's going to get a chance to bat here in this Bedlam game. Hitting 500, this is her 13th game of the year. Two out of four with seven runs scored, two runs batted in. Also made first team academic all Big 12 with a 4.0 grade point average. She'll get a chance to bat here against Lopez with the bases empty and two outs, trailing 7-1 here in the seventh inning. First pitch, swing and a miss, and that's a strike, and the count is 0-1. Heintzelman wears number 77 for the Cowgirls. Been transferred here a couple years ago from Virginia. Dallas-Fort Worth product, the 0-1. Taking, that's a strike, and the Sooners are down to their final strike to get through this game. Heintzelman, a right-handed batter, stands in. Lopez way ahead on the count at 0-2. 7-1 Sooners, the pitch. That's high, a ball and two strikes. Cowgirls would fall to 13-4 in the league, and again, they're going to finish second. So they'll play at 11-5 on Friday in the Big 12 tournament in Oklahoma City. That should be a lot of fun this year. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss, and the game is over. And it ends up 9 strikeouts in the ball game for Lopez, and Oklahoma continues their streak as they beat the Cowgirls today. They take this series 2 straight, final score of 7-1, and we'll have the third game of the series coming up at 3 o'clock. Post game ahead, this is Cowgirl Softball from Learfield IMG College.
something with your life.